Hi, and welcome back to the VSDC channel. In today's tutorial, we're going to walk you through creating animations using the movement tool. Whether you're using the free version of VSDC or have upgraded to Pro, this guide is to help you make the most of movement animation. To kick things off, it is crucial to understand that the movement effect, like all effects in VSDC, is designed to be applied within objects. Let's start with a simple task, drawing an ellipse. Once drawn, we enter it with a double click and add the movement effect right there. You can find this effect on the left toolbar or use the Shift-M shortcut. When you do this, a window will pop up. But let's just leave the settings as they are for now and click OK. Next, we decide where we want our ellipse to end up, thus creating the animation. The duration of our animation is shown on the timeline by two markers, a brown one at the start and a yellow one at the end. You can adjust these markers to control when your animation starts and its overall length. When looking at the scene, you'll notice a motion vector. For those with the Pro version, it is possible to bend this vector, creating curved paths. Simply select a point, hold down the Ctrl key, and drag to curve the path into a Bezier curve, making your animation flow more smoothly. Let's move on to the point properties. By selecting the first point, you can set its exact location and the kickoff time for your animation. The start speed parameter lets you adjust the animation speed ranging from a slow 0 to a maximum 200. You can also use the mode setting to smooth out transitions or lock your object's position. The delay duration option is handy for adding a slight pause before your animation begins, giving you precise control over timing. Now, let's explore the settings for the second point. You will notice that some options are not available here because it's not the initial point of our animation. There are also a few other differences between the points. To see what those are, we'll add another point to our animation. But keep in mind, adding extra points like this is a feature exclusive to the Pro version. Then you'll see a new yellow marker on the timeline, and you might notice that another yellow marker shifts position. The distance between them depends on the length of the vector on the stage. For example, move the last point added to the scene and you will see that its position on the timeline has also changed, because the speed is constant, but the distance is different. If you want more control, set Yes in the path start point properties for the second point, and it will allow for finer timeline adjustment. When we designate the third key as a starting point and introduce another point into our scene, the intervals between these points stay consistent. Next, let's look at the window that pops up when we add a point. By adding a new point, you'll see the option to cursor position, which places a marker exactly where the cursor is located, allowing for the addition of points in between. The standard setting, to the end of object, automatically places a marker at the object's endpoint. If you select to manual position, it gives you the ability to precisely set the marker's position, similar to cursor positioning but with specific coordinates. When you're marking the last point of a trajectory or starting a new one, a brown marker is used instead of a yellow one, indicating the beginning of a new movement path. Speed settings offer another layer of customization. When you select a layer on the timeline, you unlock extra settings for adjustments, Let's see what they are for. One such feature, time remapping, we also have a separate tutorial on it. For more details, check the link in the description or watch a video guide in the top right corner. This feature enables precise control over the animation speed by manipulating keyframes. To access the key editor, click the three dots on the right. Here you will find a graph where distance is plotted on the Y-axis and time on the X-axis. The distance represents how far along the trajectory your object moves on the stage. The markers on the timeline are highlighted in gray. And a diagonal line indicates a constant speed throughout the animation. For an example, we'll add a keyframe at the midpoint and elevate it. Then switch to Bezier curve to adjust the curve. At this moment, the animation reaches 100% of its intended distance, briefly reverses to 50%, then proceeds to complete the journey. After demonstrating this, we'll remove the keyframe. Next, we place keyframes at the edges of the gray areas and tweak the Bezier curve for each. This adjustment causes the object's speed to decrease as it approaches a point and then gradually increase, creating a more natural movement pattern. Let's move on to the next parameter, lock to parent duration, a feature available for nearly all objects. This functionality allows you to adjust the duration of objects in sync with changes to the duration of their parent object. By extending the duration using the end marker, the object's timeline stretches, but its animation timing remains unchanged. However, when you set this parameter to true and make adjustments, the spacing between the markers adjusts proportionally, effectively slowing down the animation. The next property is number of points, which is key to adjusting the smoothness of your animation's curve. Opting for a lower value results in fewer points and less smoothing, making the motion more direct. On the other hand, increasing this value up to 100 introduces more points, significantly enhancing the curve's smoothness for a more fluid animation. The final feature that we'll cover is the rotate object property, crucial for rotating the object along the curve path. For demonstration, let's switch to scene 0 and insert an arrow from the free shape templates. By adding several points, we can manipulate the arrow's movement . Activating the rotate object option in the movement layer's properties sets our arrow to rotate in alignment with its path, creating a more dynamic and visually appealing motion. Furthermore, the rotation level can be adjusted or even animated, offering complete control over how the arrow turns as it moves. And there you have it. We've covered advanced settings to enhance your animations in VSDC. If you have any questions or need further clarification, feel free to drop a comment below. Do not forget to subscribe to stay updated with the latest tips and tutorials. See you in the next video!